Hello students, hope you would have practiced the numerical problems from the first unit of current electricity. Today we are going to discuss the numerical problems from the second unit of current electricity. See, why I am discussing the second unit now? You will be having the current electricity chapter for doubt clarification session. So I am discussing the numerical problems from the second unit of current electricity. Okay. Before solving the numericals, let us discuss the expressions what are all involved in the second unit. Okay, first one, the terminal voltage V is equal to current into external resistance. External resistance we represent by the symbol R suffix E. Okay, that is whichever resistors are connected outside the cell. I is the current flowing through the cell. Then the potential drop is represented by the symbol small v, which is equal to I into small r, where I represents the current drawn from the cell, r represents the internal resistance of the cell. Then EMF of the cell E is equal to terminal voltage plus voltage drop. Then EMF of the cell can be written in terms of current and the resistance as I, current drawn from the cell, into external resistance plus internal resistance. Then from this I can write the current drawn from the cell is equal to EMF by total resistance, total resistance in the circuit. Yes. Then the internal resistance is given as EMF by terminal voltage minus 1 multiplied by external resistance. Yes, when the given resistors are connected in series, the effective resistance in the circuit is given by the sum of the individual resistors. That is, if R1, R2, R3 resistors are connected, then the effective resistance connected in series is given by Rs is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. If the given resistors are connected in parallel, then the effective resistance in parallel connection is obtained by 1 by Rp is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3 goes on like this. That is, when the number of resistors are connected in parallel, the reciprocal of resistors, effective resistance connected in parallel is equal to the reciprocal of the sum of the individual resistors connected in the circuit. Only two resistors are connected in parallel, then the effective resistance connected in parallel can be obtained by R1 R2 by R1 plus R2. Yes, this is applicable. Only two resistors are connected in parallel. Only two resistors are connected in parallel. Yes. Then how to represent the graph? The suppose if you have IV graph, that is V is taken along the x axis and I is taken along the y axis, and you have a graph like this. That is, for resistor A you are getting like this, and another one, that is the resistors connected in parallel, you are getting a graph like this. For resistors connected in series you are getting the graph B. That is, A represents the resistors connected in parallel, B represents the IV characteristic graph for resistors which are connected in series. Then okay, that is the steeper curve represents the low resistance because it is IV characteristic curve. Okay, so the slope of the curve will give you the reciprocal of the resistor. Yes, so the IV characteristic for the smaller resistor, that will be represented by the curve A, and B represents for the higher value of the resistor. Next one, when the two resistors are connected in parallel, when the two resistors are connected in parallel. If I is the current drawn from the battery, see, I take two resistors R1 and R2. Yes, they are connected in parallel to the battery. If I is the current drawn from the battery, yes, then how to calculate the current across both the resistor? We know that when the two resistors are connected in parallel, the potential difference across both the resistors will remain the same. Suppose if V is the potential difference across the cell, then the potential difference across both the resistors will remain the same because both the resistors are connected in parallel. When the two resistors are connected in parallel, the potential difference across both the resistors will remain the same. I write potential difference across R1 is equal to potential difference across R2. That is, the potential difference across the resistor R1 is equal to potential difference across the resistor R2. Now, here I can write it as the potential difference across R1 is equal to the current flowing through the resistors R1. That is, if I take I is the current drawn from the cell, the current branches out here. So I take, let I1 be the current flowing through the resistor R1 and I2 be the current flowing through the resistor R2. Then I can write potential difference across R1 is equal to I1 into R1, because V is equal to IR from Ohm's law. I1 into R1 is equal to I2 into R2. Yes, from this I can write I1 is equal to I2 R2 divided by R1. Yes, here I can write the current drawn from the cell is equal to I1 plus I2. The current drawn from the cell, if I take it as I, it branches out here as I1 and I2. So, I is equal to I1 plus I2. Yes, from this I can write I2 is equal to I minus I1. I2 is equal to I minus I1. Substitute for I1 from this equation. That is, I2 is equal to I minus I1 is equal to I2 R2 by R1. Yes, cross multiply. Take the common denominator. R1 as common denominator for both. IR1 minus I2 R2 divided by R1. That is, I2 is equal to. Cross multiplying, we get I2 R1 is equal to IR1 minus I2 R2. Which can be written as IR1 is equal to I2 R1 plus I2 R2. Take I2 R2 to this side. Then here, if I take I2 outside, you will be getting R1 plus R2. This IR1 is equal to I2 into R1 plus R2. From this, I2 is equal to IR1 by R1 plus R2. This is the expression for the current flowing through the second resistor R2. That is, when the two resistors are connected in parallel, then the current flowing through one of the resistors can be calculated by, if I take the current flowing through the second resistor as I2, the value of I2, the current through the second resistor R2, can be calculated by I into R1, where I is the current drawn from the cell, R1 is the resistor which is connected in parallel to the given resistor, divided by the sum of the two resistors. Okay, the same way we can obtain the expression for current flowing through the first resistor R1. Yes, here I can write same expression, I1 R1 is equal to I2 R2. From this I can write I2 is equal to I1 R1 by R2. Yes, we know that current drawn from the cell is equal to sum of the current flowing through the two resistors I1 plus I2. From this, substitute for I2 in this expression, I is equal to I1 plus I2 is equal to I1 R1 by R2. Yes, take R2 as a common denominator, R2. So, I1 R2 plus I1 R1 is equal to I. Cross multiply. I R2 is equal to I1 R2 plus I1 R1. Here I R2 is equal to I1 I take outside. So it becomes R1 plus R2. Yes. From this I1 is equal to I R2 by R1 plus R2. Yes. This is the way we can find out the current flowing through the two resistors when they are connected in parallel. Okay. After studying the second unit of current electricity, you know that when the two resistors are connected in parallel, the potential difference across the two resistors will remain the same, but the current flowing through the two resistors will be different. The sum of the current flowing through the two resistors connected in parallel is equal to the current drawn from the cell. Same way, if the two resistors are connected in series, that we discussed. If two resistors are connected in series, then what is the expression for the current voltage? So we have to represent the direction of the current. The direction of the current is always from the positive terminal towards the negative terminal. Here the two resistors R1 and R2 are connected in series. Let us take that. Let V be the potential difference across the cell. When the two resistors are connected in parallel, the potential difference across the two resistors will be different. Let us take, let V1 be the potential difference across R1 and V2 be the potential difference across the resistor R2. Whatever current is drawn from the cell, the same current will flow through both the resistors. Clear? When two resistors are connected in series, the current flowing through both the resistors will remain the same. That is, the current equal to the current drawn from the cell. If I is the current drawn from the cell, the current flowing through both the resistors will remain the same. That is equal to I. But when the resistors are connected in series, the potential difference across the two resistors will be different. First I write, let V1 be the potential difference across R1. So V1 can be written as, according to Ohm's law, current into resistance. I is the current flowing through the resistor R1. The value of the resistor is R1. So I into R1. And substitute for I from this equation. I is equal to V by, that is I is equal to V by R. What is the effective value of the resistance? When they are connected in series, the effective value of the resistance is sum of the two resistors which are connected in series into R1. Just I have substituted for I. I is equal to V by R, general expression. Here the effective value of the resistance is equal to R1 plus R2. So V by R1 plus R2 into R1. So V1 is equal to V R1 by R1 plus R2. That is, when the two resistors are connected in series, the potential difference across one of the resistor V1 is equal to V into R1 by R1 plus R2, where V represents the potential difference difference across the terminals of the battery. R1 represents the resistor across which you are finding the potential difference, and divide by sum of the two resistors which are connected in series. Similarly, if I want to find out the value of V2, same way, V2 is equal to the potential difference across the second resistor is equal to current flowing through the second resistor multiplied by the value of the resistor. So V2 is equal to the current flowing through the second resistor. We can write it as potential difference by the sum of the two resistors which are connected in series multiplied by R2, which is equal to V R2 by R1 plus R2. Yes. So the potential difference across the second resistor R2 is equal to, R2 is V2, which is equal to V R2 by R1 plus R2. So to do the numerical problems given in the second unit of current electricity, you have to be familiar with all these expressions. Yes, you can check the videos in the previous video section, that is theory section. You go through it, then you learn this. Okay. That is the videos given in 29th, 4th. That is April month 29th and 30th current electricity videos. Current electricity 1 and 2 videos. You go through it, then go through these problems. Today I have given only the expressions. All these expressions we have studied in the previous units. That is 29th and 30th April videos. You check, then go through the problems. Okay, then you study these expressions. Okay. Now I am going to start with the solving the numerical problems given in 8B unit. Okay. See the first question. First one it is given. The diagram is given. So from the diagram I write the data. You refer your textbook page number 201. Yes. In this question, the EMF of the cell is given as 2 volt. And the internal resistance of the cell is given as 1 ohm. And the value of the external resistance connected in the circuit is given as, external resistance always we represent by the symbol RE. Okay. That is given as 4 ohm. Okay. And you are asked to calculate, you are asked to find out what will be the readings of the ammeter and voltmeter. Ammeter will measure the current in the circuit. Voltmeter will measure the potential difference across the circuit. Okay. And two things are given here. When the key K is open. So when the key K is open, what will happen? When the key K is open, no current flows through the circuit. We know that current flows in the closed circuit, right? But when the key is open, it is an open circuit. No current flows in the circuit. So directly we can write, when the key K is open, when the key is open, current I is equal to 0. Because when the key is open, no current flows in the open circuit. So current I is equal to 0. What will be the reading of the voltmeter? Now, the voltmeter will measure the potential difference across the cell. Now, when no current is drawn from the cell, okay, the potential difference across the cell, we call it as EMF, right? From the definition of EMF, when no current is drawn from the cell, the potential difference across the terminals of the cell is called as an EMF. Yes? So, the voltmeter will read the EMF of the cell, which is equal to 2 volt. Okay? This is the condition when the key is opened. Okay? When the key K is closed, what happens? When the key is closed, then we have to find out the value of the current. That is, when the key K is closed, the expression for current is, current drawn from the cell is equal to EMF by total resistance. Yes, this is the expression we have studied. Total resistance is what? External resistance plus internal resistance of the cell. EMF of the cell is given as 2 volt divided by external resistance is given as 4 plus internal resistance is given as 1, which is equal to 2/5, which is equal to 0.4 ampere. So when the key K is closed, the current flow through the circuit is 0.4 ampere. Next, you are asked to calculate the voltmeter reading. Now the voltmeter, when the current is drawn from the cell, the potential difference across the terminals of the cell, you call it as the terminal voltage. So the voltmeter will measure the terminal voltage. Okay, the terminal voltage, the expression is the current drawn from the cell into external resistance. What is the current drawn from the cell? We have calculated 0.4 ampere. So 0.4. What is the external resistance of the cell, which is given as 4? So 4, which is equal to 1.6 volt. Yes. Second one. For questions, you refer the textbook page number 201. See the second question. A battery of EMF 3 volts supplies the current through the circuit. That is, the EMF of the cell is given as 3 volt. And the resistance can be changed. A high resistance voltmeter is connected across the battery. With the current of 1.5 ampere, the voltmeter reads 2.7 voltmeter. When the current is 1.5 ampere, so current I is equal to 1.5 ampere. Next one they have given, the voltmeter reads The voltmeter reads means the voltmeter will measure the terminal voltage. When the current is drawn from the cell, the voltmeter measures the terminal voltage. That means the terminal voltage is given as 2.7 volt. Okay. Find the internal resistance of the battery. You are asked to calculate the internal resistance of the cell. So we know the relation connecting the EMF, the terminal voltage, and the voltage drop. EMF is equal to terminal voltage plus voltage drop. See here, EMF is equal to terminal voltage plus voltage drop. Use that expression. In the place of EMF, substitute for EMF. Terminal voltage is given as 2.7 and voltage drop is not given. We find out small v is equal to 3 minus 2.7, which is equal to 0.3 volt. The voltage drop is equal to 0.3 volt. But you are asked to calculate the internal resistance of the cell. See here, in this expression, the relation connecting V and small r is voltage drop is equal to I into R. So, voltage drop V is equal to I into R, which is equal to voltage drop is given as 0.3, I you have is given as 1.5 into R. Yes, from this we can calculate R is equal to 0.3 divided by 1.5, which is equal to 3/15, which is equal to 1/5, is equal to 0.2. SI unit of resistance is ohm. So the internal resistance of the cell R is equal to 0.2 ohm. Yes, you are asked to calculate the internal resistance of the cell. Okay, come to the next question. Third question. The diagram is given. From the circuit diagram, we can write the data. The EMF of the cell is given as 1.8 volt. And the internal resistance, when the resistance value is given near the cell, that represents the internal resistance of the cell. The internal resistance of the cell is given as 2 ohm. And near the ammeter, they have not given the current, but the ohm it is given. That means the resistance offered by the ammeter is given. So, resisted offered by the ammeter, I write it as R suffix A. And one more resistance value is given, which is connected there. Let me take that one as R1. Okay. R1 is equal to 4.5 ohm. First one we have to calculate. What are all the value of external resistance connected in the circuit? In this particular sum, the resistance offered by the ammeter and the value of the resistor 4.5 ohm, these two are the externally connected resistor. So I can write the external resistance is equal to R1 plus RA, that is resistance offered by the ammeter. R1 is 4.5, RA is equal to 0.7, which is equal to 5.2 ohm. This is the external resistance connected in the circuit. We know that the total resistance is equal to external resistance plus internal resistance. Here the external resistance we have calculated as 5.2. Internal resistance is given as 2 ohm. So which is equal to 7.2 ohm. So 7.2 ohm is the total resistance connected in the circuit. Next we have to calculate. You are asked to calculate what should be the current reading of the ammeter. Ammeter will measure the current drawn from the cell. The expression for current drawn from the cell I is EMF by total resistance in the circuit. Here EMF is given as 1.8 volt and the total resistance we have calculated as 7.2 ohm, which is equal to 18/72, which is equal to 1/4. 0.25 ampere. So the current drawn from the cell or the reading of the ammeter is equal to 0.25 ampere. Next we are asked to calculate what is the potential difference across the terminal of the cell. So the expression for potential difference across the terminal of the cell is equal to V is equal to I into RE. So V is equal to terminal voltage is equal to I into RE. Here I represents the current drawn from the cell, which we have calculated as 0.25. The external resistance is RE is equal to 5.2 ohm. R external resistance means which are all the resistors connected other than the battery. Okay, outside the cell. So I is equal to 0.25 into RE is equal to 5.2. Yes, so 0.25 into 5.2 is equal to 1.3 volt. So the terminal voltage V is equal to 1.3 volt. Okay, come to the next question. Fourth question. The music system draws a current of 400 milliampere when connected to 12 volt battery. What is the resistance of the music system? In this question, the current is given as 400 milliampere. We know that the SI unit of current is ampere. So milliampere, we have to write it in terms of ampere. 1 milliampere is equal to 10 power minus 3 ampere. So 400 milliampere is equal to 400 into 10 power minus 3 ampere. Next, they have given the EMF of when connected to 12 volt battery. Yes, 12 volt battery means that voltage. Current I take it as I1, voltage I take it as V1. V1 is equal to 12 volt. That is, the terminal voltage of the battery is equal to 12 volt. And you are asked to calculate the resistance. From Ohm's law, we know that R is equal to V by I. Here, V1 by I1. V1 is equal to 12 volt. I1 is equal to 400 into 10 power minus 3. This 10 power minus 3, I take it to the numerator. So, it becomes 10 power plus 3 by 400, which is equal to 12 divided by 12 into 10 divided by 4, which is equal to 30 ohm. So the resistance, here you are asked to calculate what is the resistance of the music system. The resistance of the music system is equal to 30 ohm. Next, you are asked to find out at what battery voltage does the music system stop when the current drops to 320 milliampere. So here, I2, this current I represent by the symbol I2. When the current is equal to 320 milliampere, you are asked to calculate the potential difference. So milliampere, I convert it into ampere. That is 320 into 10 power minus 3 ampere. Here, when the current drops to 320 milliampere, you are asked to calculate the potential difference. We know that the resistance of the music system will not change. Yes, whenever, according to Ohm's law, the resistance will remain constant when the value of I and V changes. Okay. So here, the current drops to this value. Definitely, the potential difference, there will be a drop in the potential, but the resistance will remain the same. So, using same Ohm's law expression, we find the value of V2. Then V2 is equal to I2 into R. See, R is equal to V1 by I1. So, R is equal to V2 by I2. Yes. So, V2 is equal to R into I2 into R. R is how much we have calculated as 30. I2 is equal to, it is given as 320 into 10 power minus 3. So, 320 into 30 into 10 power minus 3 is equal to 9600 into 10 power minus 3. SI unit of voltage V2 is volt, which can also be written as V2 is equal to 9.6 volt. Yes. Next one. Come to the fifth question. A cell of EMF and internal resistance sensor current 1 ampere when it is connected to an external resistance of 1.9 ohm. But it sends a current of 0.5 ampere when it is connected to an external resistance of 3.9 ohm. Okay. You are asked to find the values of EMF and the internal resistance of the cell. First, we write the data. The current is given as first one, 1 ampere. So, I represent the first current as I1, which is equal to 1 ampere it is given. Second one, when it is connected to the external resistance of 1.9 ohm. So, external resistance is represented by the symbol RE. Here, R1, I write it as 1.9 ohm. And second one is given, but it sends a current of 0.5 ampere. This current I represent as I2. I2 is equal to 0.5 ampere. When it is connected to an external resistance, that resistance I represent by the symbol R2, which is equal to 3.9 ohm. Yes. Now, we know the expression for, let us take the EMF and the internal resistance as R. Okay. Let E represents EMF. EMF of the cell and small r represents the internal resistance of the cell. Okay, with this I can write the current drawn from the cell is equal to EMF E by external resistance plus internal resistance. For if the current is I1 is drawn from the cell, then EMF of the cell divided by the R1 resistor connected as an external resistance plus internal resistance of the cell. Substitute for I1, I1 is equal to 1. It is given as 1 ampere. EMF is not given. We have taken it as E divided by R1 is given as 1.9 plus R internal resistance. Cross multiply will get 1.9 plus R is equal to E. This you take it as the first equation. From these two data, frame the second equation. That is, the current drawn from the cell I2 is equal to EMF of the cell divided by the external resistance 3.9 plus internal resistance R. Cross multiply, substitute for I2, 0.5 is equal to EMF of the cell divided by 3.9 plus R. Cross multiply this one. 0.5 into 3.9 plus R is equal to E. From this we get on cross multiplication 1.95 plus 0.5 R is equal to E. This you take it as second equation. Okay. This equation 1, equation 2. Now you write the equation, second equation here 1.95 plus 0.5 R is equal to E. This is our second equation. Same second equation I have written here. Now subtract equation 2 from 1. Yes, that is equation 1 minus equation 2. 1.9 minus 1.95 is equal to minus 0.05 R minus 0.11 R minus 0.5 R is equal to plus 0.5 R. E minus E is equal to 0. From this I can write 0.5 R is equal to 0.05. When I take this one to this side, this become plus. R is equal to 0.05 divided by 0.5. Multiply both numerator and denominator by 10. We will get 0.5 divided by 5, which is equal to 0.1 ohm. So the external resistance, internal resistance R is equal to 0.1 ohm. Yes. Now substitute the value of R in equation 1. What is equation 1? I write equation 1. 1.9 plus R is equal to EMF. 1.9 plus, what is the value of R we have calculated? 0.1. 0.1 is equal to E. 1.9 plus 0.1 is equal to 2. It is EMF of the cell. That is EMF of the cell E is equal to 2 volt. So this question, you are asked to find the values of internal resistance and the EMF of the cell. Okay. So frame two equations, solve it and find the values of R and E. Yes. Students, before going through this video, you have to go through the videos of, that is previous videos of current electricity. I have given you the dates also. The current electricity video dates, 29th of April and 30th of April you go through. Then go through these problems. Okay, practice the problems. And all these problems I will send it in the form of notes. You copy it. And when you come for the doubt clarification session, that time I will be clarifying your doubt based on current electricity. Because this chapter is a new chapter. Solving numerical problems are new to you. So practice well. Then attend the doubt clarification session. Okay.